trying to get pregnant, but it just ain't happening, I'm gonna tell you how ultrasound can do just that, starting right now. Hello, mama dolls. It's me, Babs, your favorite sonographer. I'm an OBGYN sonographer, and I've been doing this for 7 years. And I picked up some knowledge along the way. So congratulations, you've decided to have a baby, or two, or three, but it's not happening for you. You're doing all the right things. You're taking your vitamins. You're working out.
Why is he still wearing his watch?
You're tracking your period. You're eating healthy. And you're doing it all the time. Okay, I'm ready. But it's not happening. What's next? Now, I don't know too much about fertility treatments because I don't work in a fertility center, but I know that the first thing that your doctor or midwife is going to order is an ultrasound. Make sure you watch this video in its entirety because I'm going to explain the basics of everything, to the best of my knowledge, on how ultrasound can tell you why you're not getting pregnant. So first things first, a pelvic ultrasound is going to look at your uterus and your ovaries. Why did I do that? I don't know. But anyway, it's gonna look at your uterus and your ovaries. It's going to check if there's anything physical that could be preventing you from getting pregnant. For example, fibroids or polyps. Polyps are usually located inside of the cavity or the endometrium. Fibroids can be located anywhere, but sometimes they're also located inside of the cavity, or they're around the cervix, blocking the entrance of the sperm. Now, like I said, I don't work in the fertility field, but your doctor or your midwife might send you to get an ultrasound during the secretory phase of your menstrual cycle. That occurs right before your period. That's when the lining of your uterus gets thick, preparing the uterus for possible implantation. If the lining isn't thick enough, there may not be enough blood flow going into that region to support a pregnancy. It might be an indication of a hormonal imbalance. I don't know. The morphology of the uterus might be looked at too. I mean, it's going to be looked at anyway, but just in case we do find something about the uterus that it's shaped in a different way, could that be preventing pregnancy? The next things that are commonly examined are the ovaries. Now, an ultrasound can be done at any time during your menstrual cycle, but timing is pretty critical. During the follicular phase of your ovaries will be developing cysts. Now, these cysts are functional cysts. These are follicular cysts. They're perfectly normal. We need these cysts in order to ovulate. During that time, multiple follicles start maturing and they are round. They look black in ultrasound, and one of them will get really, really, really big and then burst out an egg. Your doctor wants to know, are your ovaries developing follicular cysts? Do you have multiple big, fat, juicy cysts about to burst? Are you fertile myrtle? But what if we don't find follicular cysts, normal cysts, right before ovulation? What if we find abnormal cysts? An ovary that might look abnormal because of cysts would be, one example, a cluster of very small cysts in the peripheral, or is it the periphery? What did I write? In the periphery of the ovaries. I think that's right. These make the ovaries polycystic, caused by PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Or are some of these cysts bloody, meaning there's blood inside? They're also called endometriomas, caused by endometriosis. PCOS can make it difficult to conceive due to irregular periods and I think hormonal imbalances. I think you have like a higher, not you in particular, but maybe you, yeah, if you there have PCOS, I think you have a higher level of testosterone, I think, and your periods are definitely irregular. Endometriosis can sometimes make it difficult to conceive too. Endometriosis can cause scarring or adhesions that could block the fallopian tubes, preventing the egg from traveling through the tube and meeting the sperm. Speaking of blocked tubes, normal regular fallopian tubes cannot really be examined through ultrasound, but if there is fluid within the tubes, that could usually be seen. Also, if you've ever had pelvic inflammatory disease, which is an infection in the pelvis causing pain and pus and just all kinds of nastiness, that could cause infertility if it goes untreated for a long time. So let's say you had it, you've been treated, what's left over could be scar tissues, could be adhesion. Now listen, I'm not a doctor. Maybe I should have dived into that particular topic a little bit more, but I didn't. I just kind of threw it out there as a possibility. But yes, pelvic inflammatory disease could cause infertility, could cause blockage of your tubes. Now, how can ultrasound help you get pregnant? Well, there's a procedure called blah, 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 something. I have a hard time pronouncing it, so I'm just gonna leave it down here, where we insert fluid through the fallopian tubes. And if we don't see the fluid coming out at the other end, that means your tube is blocked or tubes are blocked. And we can only see that with ultrasound. If you find out that you have one or two blocked tubes, that will tell you the chances of fertility treatments working for you. And it can help you with other options. Another procedure that could also be done is called a sonohysterogram. That is when we insert fluid through the cervix into the cavity of the uterus, kind of open it up like a balloon so we can see inside of the cavity and just check out the area to see if there are any polyps or fibroids. Now, if there is anything inside, you're not really going to get pregnant. That would have to be taken care of before going any fertility treatments or before trying to get pregnant on your own. If you're going through fertility treatments, ultrasound is used to help retrieve eggs from your ovaries. The doctor needs to see what they're doing. So an ultrasound is used to help guide them through the pelvic region and to your ovaries. Girl, just keep trying. Like, eventually it's gonna happen. Everything's all right with you. Like, just keep going. And also, I am about to launch a new channel. I am separating my story times and regular videos from my ultrasound videos. So I am making two separate channels. This channel will be just about ultrasound, and the other channel will be more fun stuff. So stay tuned for those and check out my other videos that I'm going to leave somewhere here. Ciao!